In the tavern one night we were sitting, I'm sure 'twas the last week in March. At our drinks we were cautiously sipping, to ensure that our throats didn't parch. We played music both lively and decent, to bolster our spirits and hopes. And we gazed on the females adjacent, and remarked on their curves and their slopes, till this gent wandered into our session, and decided to join in the tunes. Without waiting to ask our permission, he pulled out a large pair of soup spoons. Our teeth in short time we were gritting, as he shook and he rattled his toys, and the company's eardrums were splitting with his ugly mechanical noise. Hopping spoons off our heads to provoke us, he continued the music to kill. Whether hornpipes, slow airs, or polkas, they all sounded like pneumatic drills. Then he asked if we'd play any faster, for his talent he wished to display. With a grin on the face of the bastard, like the cat as she teases her prey. Our feelings by now were quite bloody, and politely we asked him to quit. We suggested a part of his body where these spoons might conveniently fit. This monster we pestered and hounded, we implored him with curses and prayers. But alas, our appeals resounded in the desert between his two ears. When I went out the back on a mission, he arrived as I finished my leak. He says, "This is a mighty fine session. I think I'll come here every week." When I heard this, with rage I was leaping. No more of this torture I'd take. I looked round for a suitable weapon to silence this damned rattlesnake. With a bite I assailed my tormentor, and I swung in a frenzy of hate, till his bones and his skull were in splinters, and his health in a very poor state. And when I was no longer able to forestall any last minute hitch, I took hold of the gear changing cable, and I strangled the son of a bitch. At the end of my onslaught ferocious, I stood back and I surveyed the scene. The state of the place was atrocious, full of pieces of man and machine. At the spoons player's remains I was staring. His condition was really no joke, for his nose was stuffed with ball bearings, and his left eye was pierced by a spoke. At the sight I was feeling quite squeamish, so I washed up and went back inside. Then I drank a half gallon of Beamish, for my throat in the struggle had dried. Unpolluted by cutlery's clattered, the music was pleasant and sweet. For the rest of the night nothing mattered, except the tunes and the tapping of feet. At the inquest the following September, the coroner said, "I conclude the deceased by himself was dismembered, for no sign could be found of a feud. And the evidence shows, and the fact is, as reported to me by the guards, he indulged in the foolhardy practice of trick-cycling in public house yards. So, if you're desperately keen on percussion, and to join in the tunes you can't wait, be you Irishman, German, or Russian, take a lesson from his awful fate. If your spoons are the best silver-plated, or the humblest of cheap stainless steel, if you play them abroad,